Hello, welcome to my class. Today we are going to discuss about parts of belt conveyor. So, parts of belt conveyor. So, in case of parts of belt conveyor, first of all we need to discuss about the conveyor belts. Okay, so in case of conveyor belts, basically we are discussing about what is the belt's construction, what are the covers, what are the materials by which this belt are being made. So in case of this, you must know that this belt, this conveyor belt which supports and convey the load, it is a very essential and important component of any kind of belt conveyor. Mostly common type of conveyor belting is rubber or plastic covered textile belting, where this internal carcass of woven fabric is given the longitudinal strength. Now, apart from this, rubber or plastic coated textile belt, several type of metallic belt is also used. Okay, so in case of this type of belt conveyor, now basically this rubber plastic based textile belt, these are very cheap and most widely used nowadays. Okay, now in case of belt construction, if you see, suppose this is the cross sectional part of a belt. Okay, so we are going to discuss about the construction of belt. Okay, so suppose this is the cross sectional area of the belt. Now cotton fabric ply constructed rubber covered belting is the mostly used belt for flattened truck belt conveyor. Okay, now in this case, if this is the cross sectional area, suppose this is the cover for belt, and inside the cover there is a carcass like this. So this is actually known as carcass. Okay, now this carcass consists of one or more piles of woven fabric, of solid woven fabric impregnated with rubber or plastic mix, which after vulcanization that binds the piles together. Okay, so inside this carcass there is one or multiple piles available like this, and this over here, this looks like this. Okay, these are basically wooden or fabric piles of item. Now these piles, the fabric used is whatever fabric used over here, that is actually made of threads of cotton or polyamide of any other synthetic material, or combination of that cotton or polyamide type of material. Evenly after firmly woven, these type of piles, they are being vulcanized just to make stronger bond between the piles, and so that all of these piles can stick together, and based on this carcass the cover is given. Okay, now the carcass is covered by special type of wear and impact resisting rubber compound or plastic. Now protection of this carcass, layer or layers of open mesh or cot fabric, which is actually known as breaker, that may be placed between the cover and the carcass, or it may be embedded in the inside the cover. Okay, so for this, first of all you must know the cover is made of, this cover is made of plastic or rubber or PVC type of material. Number two, the fabric made of cottons or polyamide constructs the carcass after vulcanization. Now for this type of belt, number of fabric piles vary from 3-4 with 300 mm to maximum of 12 or 14 for 2000 mm belt width. Okay, now number of piles that can vary within a specific range for a specific belt width. Now by this way, this type of conveyor belt are being made, and our main objective for constructing this conveyor belt to make the belt more strong so that it can carry bulk material with the proper time. Since we have already discussed about the belt covers, different type of belt covers, you know, so you must understand that all of these belt covers are designated by the IS standard. So basically IS standard, that is basically implies, or that basically states, the grade of the cover, the type of belting defined by the full thickness, breaking strength in case of kilonewton per meter, and number of piles. Okay, by this, all of the conveyor belts with this type of grade, these are being designated. Now if you see a conveyor belt, suppose its designation is IS 1891 P1 N17-250 by 4. So this thing actually shows, this part IS 1891 P1, that is actually showing the IS standard of 1891 part 1 is to 1994, so 1994, so that is the IS standard, and the belt cover grade is N17. The belt cover grade is N17, which is already we have discussed over here, and the breaking strength of the belt is 250 kilonewton per meter with 4 piles of carcass available in the belt. So 4 piles of carcass available in the belt. So by this way we can designate a belt for a certain conveyor system. Now this is done for this type of covers, where this type of covers are available. Now in case of steel cord belting, this is also designated in a separate way, where this prefix ST is used, and after ST the breaking strength that is given in case of kilonewton per meter. Okay, so this is a designation for a steel cord belting. The next thing what we need to understand, that is the belt width. So in case of belt width, the otherwise agreed between the manufacturers and buyers, the standard belt width of belting as per IS specifications are given, and it's supposed started from 300 to it goes up to 2000 millimeter. Okay, with a tolerance up to plus minus of 5 millimeter up to 500 millimeter. This is belt width and plus minus of 1% of the belt width for higher. Okay, so this is the belt width. Now therefore you need to understand about the belt slicing. There is belt slicing where two end of the belt may be joined either by metallic belt fastener or by vulcanization process. Okay, then there is the idlers or idler rollers. So idlers or the rollers, that they are used in a certain spacing for some supporting the active side and the return side of the belt, and they are actually called idlers. They are basically the rollers, and there are two type of idlers. They are used in belt conveyor. Number one is the straight carrying or return idler, which are used for supporting the active side of the belt for a flat belt, and also supports the return belt in a flat orientation, both for flat and trough belt. Okay, so for flat belt, both side, active side and return side, the idlers are used, flat idlers, and for trough belt, only flat idlers are used for the return side. Okay, and troughing idler, a set of so number one is the flat belt idler, number two hoche troughing idler. Okay, so flat belt idler, that is used for flat belt purpose, and in case of trough belt only return purpose. In case of flat belt, both active purpose, active way and return way, both side, and for trough belt conveyor, that is for only return side. And this troughing idler, this trough belt idler, they are in a set of 2 or 3 or 5 idlers at a time. They are being supported by the trough belt conveyor. Okay, now this idler generally made from steel tubes, and this diameter of two ends of this diameter of the two end of this type of roller or idler, they are same, and the tube are mounted on the artification bearing over a fixed steel spindle. The ends of the spindles are flat machined to the standard dimension for quick fixing in slots for idler structure. Okay, and the dimension of this idler, they are also standardized by the BIS standard, and their angle is also trough angle, they are also made by the BIS standard, like of 15 degree, 20 degree, 25 degree, 30 degree, likewise. Okay, now this idler spacing is also important, and the spacing of the idlers in the loaded run is a functional of bulk weight, function of bulk weight of materials and width of the belt. Okay, now the next thing you need to understand, that is the conveyor pulley. Now in case of conveyor pulley, at each side of two ends of a belt conveyor, one large diameter pulley is installed against which the belt turns and changes direction. Okay, these pulleys are called terminal or bent pulley. So number one, you know, terminal or bent pulley, where the drive is imparted to the belt through the friction by one of the terminal pulleys and that type of pulley, that is known as also the drive pulley. Okay, as the conveyor belt passes around these bent pulleys, the piles of the belts, they are elongated in proportion to the distance of the ply from the center of the pulley. Okay, the differential elongation of one ply over the other is taken up by the rubberized bonding between two piles. Got it that part? Now, the larger the pulley, less the differential elongation between the piles occurred, and hence the less tendency of ply separation also occurred. This is the basic reason behind why pulleys are made large. The surface of this pulley that may be bare smooth or may be covered up to a thickness of around 6 to 12 millimeter by rubber or different type of ceramic layer with some grooves cutting inside of that. Okay, and which actually reduce the friction between the pulleys and the belt. And these pulleys are also mounted on heavy duty anti-friction bearings, which is suitable in case of any bearing housing. And the drives, there is also, after this conveyor pulley, since you have known this, there is a drive pulley. So you must know the next thing, that is the drives for belt conveyor. So in case of drive, the belt conveyor are generally driven by the high end pulley where the material is discharged. The drive pulley is connected to the drive motor through suitable speed reduction gearbox and flexible shaft coupling. Okay, now the drive of an inclined conveyor is necessarily includes a braking device which prevents the downward movement of the loaded belt in case of power failure at the motor. Another thing that is very important, that is the take-ups, or it is also called the belt tensioning device. Okay, now endless conveyor belt, after being threaded through the entire length of the conveyor, that need to be tightened so that the sufficient frictional force is developed between the drive pulley and the belt to make the belt move. Okay, this belt works under tension and that's why the take-up is very needed. And the belt conveyor generally have a screw type of or gravity type of counterweight as a take-up unit. The next thing you need to understand, that is the loading and unloading devices. So we are actually discussing different parts of a belt conveyor. So this loading and unloading devices is also an important thing for any kind of belt conveyor. Free flowing material that can be directly delivered from a hopper, bin or storage pile through a chute, and the delivery rate being controlled by a regulating gate at the hopper. So by this way you can easily control the flow rate in case of a belt conveyor. And for unloading of the material and the end of the head pulley, no device is required exactly, excepting the proper chute to guide the discharge material. Now in case of unloading place, there may be a separate type of any other type of conveyor devices available. Maybe there is a stacking devices available. So there are different material handling equipment is available at the case of, at the end of this unloading devices. Okay, now this type of unloading devices, a belt tripod is also consist of two pulley, which is actually consist of two pulley, a comparable size of the head pulley supported with a fixed or movable frame is attached at the unloading part of this conveyor belt. And before this, when this unloading part is done, then there is belt cleaners. Now belt cleaners, it is also important thing for any kind of belt conveyor for cleaning the outer surface of the belt as a wiper or scraper for removing the dust particle or extra load on the belt. Okay, a rotary brass type of cleaner is normally used for wet and sticky materials which is being carried by any kind of belt, and to clean the inner surface of belt if needed, a scraper is also placed near the end of the return run before the tail end of the pulley.